This is the Reality Radio Network on Telstar 5 Transponder 5 and on the internet at realityradionetwork.com.
And now, Sherry Talk Radio.
And welcome to the show. I'm Sherry Schreiner. Tonight is listener call-in night, listener call-in line 260-356-2611. Go ahead and call in with comments or questions. I'm just going to be doing that tonight for both hours of the show. Interesting week this week. I've been busy. Put a bunch of new articles over at thewatcherfiles.com. Bunch of stuff on giants this week. The Lord has led me into the area of giants. I'm not sure I'm ever out of the area, but a different focus on something he's trying to show me, and I haven't grasped it yet. And so I haven't really started working on my own material yet on it, but I will, and I'm sure that's when he'll start showing me things he wants me to see on it. It's just been an incredible week. The book is out. Aliens on the Internet is out. You can buy it at iUniverse.com. I have the ad on all of my sites, almost about four or five of them. I haven't reached all 19 yet. but you can go to my blogger or Sherry Talk Radio. It's out a lot sooner than I thought. I thought it had at least two or three more weeks before that came out. And it's already out, so that's nice. It'll be at least 4 weeks before it hits Amazon. And I don't even need to see my own copy yet. I guess that's in the mail. So it's out. It's exciting. Listener call in line 260-356-2611. I was looking at a website today by J.L. Navarro, and I'm not even sure who this guy is. He sounds like a columnist or a commentator or something. And he mentions my name in regards to this prophet Yahweh, more doggedly in the fact because I call this prophet Yahweh a false prophet, and that his UFO summings down in Las Vegas is a holographic, it's in a fake. And you know what? I called that 2 seconds after it started. I don't even have to see this UFO. I mean, when you hear somebody telling you that they're a prophet of Yahweh's, and I'm going to come back to this, this is going to be really interesting, folks. He's calling himself the prophet of Yahweh, and that Yahweh is telling through voices in his head to call down these UFOs, okay? Now, you know, there's always a game going on, especially when it comes to the intelligence agencies, especially when it comes to the Vatican or the CIA. There's always a game, and if this didn't have every marking of a game in it, I wouldn't have thought twice. I might have given this whole thing a second chance, but it had all the earmarks of a game. And one of the biggest things about their games is what are they targeting? You know, we've had all kinds of false prophets throughout the ages, and you know, they come calling themselves God or Messiahs, but never do they single out the name of Yahweh. Although a lot of Lord's prophets do call him Yahweh, this guy comes calling himself Prophet Yahweh. And so there's the game right there. They're targeting Yahweh, the name, to make everybody who calls on the name of Yahweh look bad. And that's basically what they do whenever they have something going on in one of their games. They target a group, they target or an area, and they make it look bad, like the OKC bombing. They wanted to make militias look bad. And so they had Tim McVeigh, who was never even part of Elohim City in Oklahoma City, just some place he stopped by on his way through to Oklahoma City. But they jumped on that to make that whole militia movement over at Elohim City look bad. And then you've got the Waco disaster, where anybody who's living in a group in a communal type atmosphere is to look bad. And there's something wrong with communal type atmospheres. I mean, there wasn't any evidence that they're violent people. That there was anything wrong going on. And I'm talking about the David Koresh fiasco and the government and their attempt to make communal living look bad. I mean, they just attack. There's always a target area, a target group that they want to attack and condition the public to think that they're bad. And so it's just another game of theirs. And voices in his head, I mean, come on, folks. We know ELF, and I've been talking about ELF forever, about their voice-to-skull technology that our government has, and how these women heard voices to kill their children, and how these other people have heard voices to go and shoot people, and they become serial killers and psychopaths. And so, you know, the Lord never speaks to your head. He never speaks to your head, but the government will. The military will. They will use their voice-to-skull technology that they have patents for, and I have patents that they have for this technology listed in the articles on my website. And that's what they do. That's what they target people with. And so this guy really thinks he's hearing from God. I have no doubt that in believing that this guy probably really does think he's hearing from God, because that's how they do it. That's how they play it. They can mimic sounding like they're God. You know, they'll quote scripture. They'll use archaic language. They'll mimic words that they'll see online that other people have used in prophecies and stuff. And they've learned the lingo. They've learned the lingo. And so they probably do have this guy very deceived into thinking he's hearing from the Lord. But if you look at this guy, and then you look at his picture, first thing I thought was, this guy's a Muslim. You know, he's got the turban on thing going on his head, and I don't think I've read anywhere where he claims to be Muslim. But he has Muslim written all over him. And you say, well, is that a bad thing? Well, yeah. I mean, Islam is an arm of Satanism. It was created by the Vatican. It was Muhammad's wife who was working for agents from the Vatican to convince him that he was a prophet, that the things he was saying were of God. I mean, it took a lot of work from his wife to convince him that he was a prophet, because he was just convinced that he was being bothered by evil spirits. And he was. And so that whole thing is a charade, this whole Islam thing. And whenever you see Islam and Muslims, the CIA isn't far behind. I mean, they're always right there. And another thing is that, you know, I haven't done a code on them, haven't done a Bible code on this whole thing. But if I did, I wouldn't be surprised at what I'd see. You know, I would go by my hunches any day over 98% of what I read and see on the Internet of what people think. Because, you know, my hunches, I have never had to apologize to one single person about one of my hunches or one of the things that I've come out with about them or have stated. I've never had to apologize. And so, you know, so far I've just been going on my own discernment and what I feel about this prophet Yahweh. And I'd take it to the bank, and then people are just going to say, well, you got it from the code. I haven't even looked at his code. And if I did look at a code, then they'll confuse it all and say, well, she's basing everything she saw on the code. And it's like, I haven't even looked at this guy's code yet. I didn't even know what his full name was until I was reading J.L. Navarro's site today. This guy's name was Ramon Watkins, or Raymond Watkins, going by the name Prophet Yahweh. And so I find it interesting that he would even mention my name in his article on his site. And this whole thing with the UFO, it's obvious, and I've stated it on my blogger, it's a holographic. You know, I've talked to retired military intelligence agents. They agree. They say the same thing. It's a hoax. And, you know, what Air Force Base is, Nellis Air Force Base is right there. I mean, come on. You know, in Las Vegas, we know. We already know from the horses themselves, Sananda, Germain, and Maitreya, that there's a UFO ship out above Las Vegas. We already know from their own material that they have a ship out there above Las Vegas. And so, yeah, it's a very big ship, and all they have to do is call it down when they want to call it down. You know, and they're going to do it when they're ready for disclosure, when they want to start forcing disclosure on the world. They'll just uncloak their ship, because right now it's cloaked, so you can't see it. You know, all they have to do is uncloak it. it's been there, you know.